Natural climate solutions are solutions around all of the ecosystems on the planet, our forests, our grasslands, our wetlands, that can address climate change. They already absorb a huge amount of carbon. How can we work with those ecosystems to both reduce emissions from those ecosystems as well as enhance their sequestration? They act as a huge giant sink for carbon.
The word natural is really important. We didn't have to intervene for all of human history making these systems do what they do. Now, though, we need them to do more of it.
At least 20% of the total climate solutions will come from our lands. They are available today. We don't need to wait for technofixes that will come decades down the line.
It makes no sense at all to talk about carbon capture and sequestration as a technological solution without thinking about what that is relative to a natural sequestration.
We know there are things that we can be doing to enhance how food is produced and reduce emissions from land use from the agriculture sector. We know that there are things that we can do today to be restoring forests, to be incentivizing different forestry practices. Decarbonizing energy alone is not sufficient to address the scale of threat that we face with climate change. If we start recognizing what our ecosystems do today to already be absorbing so much carbon, then we start to recognize this is actually a critical biological bridge to be able to get to deeper decarbonization pathways from the energy sector that we cannot do without. We've got to get the science for natural climate solutions really watertight so that we can demonstrate to politicians, to corporates, that this is a serious sector.
In California, we have a comprehensive climate change regulatory program that includes a cap and trade mechanism with a role for forests. This is the first one in the world that actually allows forest landowners to produce offsets that regulated entities like utilities can submit to meet the requirements of the law. There's a parallel revenue stream that's being generated from the auction of the permits. That is producing more than $1 billion for Californians.
In many other parts of the world, you have forest-dependent communities, you have indigenous communities who know very well how to protect their natural environment. They see the natural world and their own world as much more integrated.
20% of the world's forest carbon is found in indigenous lands. So this means that if we're gonna be serious about finding solutions to climate and serious about finding solutions to conservation, then that means we need to be engaging indigenous people and local communities.
We've got to bring multiple parties together to recognize that there are shared objectives.
The role of the private sector really coming forward and saying, what's good for climate mitigation can also be good for business. This is really not a trade-off anymore. We have to have policies that stimulate the enabling environment. We need to have a price for carbon. We need to have the right mechanisms where credits can be offered to businesses that are facing steeper costs to abate emissions in other ways.
We need the full force of the and the full creativity of the financial services industry to come behind helping us find these solutions. Get from us science-based NGOs, academic organizations, what we all know, because we know a ton, and help us convert that into investable structures.
We need to find new ways of bringing private sector actors in, of unlocking the entrepreneurial spirit of people around the world to shape some of these solutions. The Nature Conservancy has relationships, it has land assets, it had field programs around the world. If we can leverage all of that, then the Nature Conservancy can play a very, very important role in addressing the climate challenge.